Hi, my name's Steve. Welcome aboard my narrowboat home, Moreland Rose. Please join me as I take a slow boat through Britain. With the Chugabug crew now heading back to the Trent and Mersey Canal, I have another couple of nights at Tixall Wide before continuing my own solo journey along the Staffs and Worcester Canal. But we'll keep in touch. Tixall is a popular spot for boaters, with the canal widening out like a lake. This was demanded by the then owner of Tixall Hall, Thomas Clifford, as recompense for allowing the canal to be routed through his land. I'll remove the chimney before I set off. I don't want to lose it to any overhanging branches or low bridges. It is a little windier than I expected, but it's a lovely sunny day. Tixall Hall was demolished in 1927, although the gatehouse and the estate farm still remain. These floods seem to have attracted the bird watchers. Very soon we come to our first lock of the day. we continue to follow the edge of Cannock Chase as we cross another river. As we have seen so often, the railway keeps the canal company. Do you remember that the Birmingham and Faisley section of the Coventry Canal had name plaques on the bridges? Those bridges weren't numbered, but the Staffs and Worcester produced plaques with names and numbers. I bet these moorings are a bit noisy next to the railway line. After a beautiful start to the day, there are now a few spots of rain. Ah, the British weather. there's an unusual looking shed. Work is being carried out here to reconnect the canal to the River Sow and renovate a boat link into the heart of Stafford. At least this artwork is of a better standard than much of the graffiti along the canal. The rain is starting again. Fortunately, my planned stop is after this next bridge. I have to go to the doctor for my annual checkup. This is handy for getting a bus to Stafford train station, and there's a shopping complex close by. I often put a bird feeder out if there's a convenient bush by the towpath. I get the occasional unusual visitor. Clean bill of health from the doctor and a bright blue sky, so I'll get underway again. Although the winter sun is truly welcome, it does make forward vision a bit difficult when it's so low in the sky. I'm not sure of the purpose of that sign. Where is there to go left? I had phoned ahead to Stafford Boat Club to see if they would accept a delivery for me and to let me moor for a few nights. They were brilliant and said, no problem. a great mooring and very helpful people. I got a few jobs done, and they have their own bar. After a week, it's time to get going again. There is quite a strong wind blowing as I set off. One of the reasons for staying at the boat club for a week was that this lock was closed for repair and has only just reopened. I can see by the gap between the gates that the lock is set for me, and all I have to do is open the gates. There is a fair amount of water leaking through that top gate. Some people will say that I should wind the paddles down with my windlass, but it's perfectly acceptable to control the lowering of the paddle with your hand on the spindle. What is not acceptable is to let it drop down with a bang. That can shear the connecting pin at the bottom. There are some lovely offside properties along here with gardens running right down to the water's edge. People ask me if I get lonely cruising by myself. The simple answer for me is no. There's always something to see along the cut, and in general the boating fraternity are a welcoming crowd, as evidenced at Stafford Boat Club. However, I will say that it's not for everyone. It may look idyllic when the sun's shining, but if you are subject to depression, that can change in an instant, just like the British weather. Wind has made it tiring cruising today, so I'll pull back from the lock landing and put the kettle on before carrying on. If you enjoyed this vlog, click the thumbs up, and if you feel in a good mood, leave a comment. Until next week, stay safe, see you soon.